Hi, I am Lakshmi Priyapati from Department of Mathematics, BITS Pilani, Hyderabad Campus, India. I would like to thank to the organizer of Cosmology from Home Conference 2021 for giving me a chance to present my paper here. I am working with the supervision of Professor Bibhudat Mishra. Now, the title of my topic is Dynamics of Acute Gravity with Variable Deceleration Parameter. In my outline of presentation, I include this point. First of all, I would like to explain introduction of acute gravity. Then after that, I'll move into the part that some important information that will help to relate in the acute gravity. After that, the requirement of acute gravity in the action formula. Then I'll enter into the mathematical formalism part. And next models by taking the hybrid scale factor. And after that, I'll enter into the analysis of the model. Then finally, I will explain the results and discussion part. So first, I will explain the introduction of acute gravity. As we know, GR can be explained into two ways. First one is in teleparallel representation or curvature representation. In teleparallel representation, the torsion term is non-zero. And in curvature representation, the curvature term is non-zero. But the torsion and the non-metricity term in curvature representation, that term is zero. Also, in general relativity is basically a geometric theory which is formulated in the Riemannian metrical space, and it has a great role within modified theories of gravity, and also it helps to explain the gravitational field action. Here we proposed an extension of the symmetric teleparallel gravity, in which the gravitational action L is an arbitrary function of the non-metricity Q and trace of the energy momentum tensor. Mathematically, you can represent as L equals to F of Q, T. Next, here we impose two cosmological models. First one is linear model, and second one is n plus 1 power in the non-metricity term and trace of the unlinear in trace of the energy momentum tension. So one of the simplest possibility of extending Einstein gravity is to introduce an arbitrary function F of the Riemann-Skalar R into the gravitational action. The mathematical expression is this. Here, Lm represents the Lagrangian matter. G represents the determinant of the metric, and d4x is the four velocity vector. Here, as I already explained, Q is the non-metricity term. So, a second approach to extend the Einstein-Hilbert action is to assume the existence of a non-minimal coupling between geometry and the matter part. Next, I will explain some crucial information which helps to relate in the acute gravity. So in that section, I want to explain, before publishing that acute gravity, our prominent scientists discovered some term, introduced some term that helps to further study in acute gravity. So here I mentioned some important terms and that term was described by which scientist? Aldrovandi and Pereira have presented a systematic discussions on the teleparallel gravity. Ferrero and Fironi have solved the particle horizon problem in flat FRW space-time. Next, Linder has shown the result for cosmic acceleration by taking the behavior of the effective equation of state parameter with respect to the function, which describes the exponential dependency on torsion scalar. Next, Harco and his group have obtained the initial inflationary phase, the matter-dominated expansion, and the late-time accelerating phase in the FTT gravity. Next, Capasilo and his group have used the observational data of Big Bang nucleosynthesis to constrain the FT gravity model for the power law, exponential law, and square root of exponential law. Ottolora and Robukas have presented the Gödel type geometries and its solution in FT gravity. By taking this information, we are working with FUT gravity. Next, I want to explain the requirement of FUT gravity in the action. Here, FQT is an extended gravity of FQ gravity. As all of you know that, extended gravity is an alternate theory of gravity, which is the starting point of our universe. That was first explained by Einstein and Hilbert. Also, extended theory of gravity extended theory of gravity is the potential to explain the accelerated expansion of the universe, and also that extended gravity. The non-matricity matter can also help the accelerating expansion of the universe. At the classical level, several approaches are presented to address the observational results concerning the structure, formation, and dynamics of the universe. But the source is ongoing to find a good extended theory of gravity. FQT leads to a non-conservation of energy momentum tensor, which may be responsible to achieve a late-time cosmic acceleration in the models. Next, I come to the part of mathematical formalism. Here, we take the gravitational action is this. Lm represents the Lagrangian matter. And e to the power 4x is the four velocity vector, and g is the determinant of the metric. Then by varying this action with respect to the metric and the connection, we'll get the generalized field equation. From that generalized field equation, as we know, this one is the superpotential tensor, this one is the non-matricity tensor. T mu nu is the trace of the energy momentum tensor. By putting all the values here, we will get one three pressure equation and one density equation. Here I mentioned all the formulas. This one is the formula of superpotential tensor. This one is another formula. By putting all this value in the field equation, we will get four equation. Now, I will explain cosmological evolution of the FLRW universe in FQT gravity. Here we take FLRW metric, because to know the background history of the universe, we consider FLRW metric. H is the Hubble parameter equals to A dot upon A, and the dilation term T equals to N dot upon A. By solving this equation 7, we get the non-metricity term equals to 6H square upon N square. And this one is the energy momentum tensor, and big theta mu nu equals to diagonal of this. Next, by using this two notation and also by applying this formula, we get these two field equation. From that field equation, we will calculate the pressure and the energy density value. In the standard case, we take N equals to 1, then Q is reduced to 6H square. This one is the energy density term equals to this, and the pressure equals to this. Here we consider two cases. In first case, we have taken the linear model, and capital F equals to del F upon del Q equals to A, and G tilde equals to B. Also here we used hybrid scale factor. Now I want to explain something about hybrid scale factor. A of t equals to e to the power alpha t into t to the power beta. This one is the hybrid scale factor. From that scale factor, we calculate h equals to alpha plus beta by t. Hybrid scale factor is a combination of exponential law and the power law. So A of t equals to e to the power alpha t, t to the power beta. If alpha equals to 0, then that term is completely reduces to the power law factor. If beta equals to 0, then that term is completely reduces to the exponential factor. As we know that, power law factor dominates the early evolution of the universe, and the exponential law dominates the late time evolution of the universe. So here we use this hybrid scale factor and calculating the pressure and energy density and the equation of state parameter. And after that, in that slide, I represent the energy density parameter, energy density graph. In energy density, four parameters are associated: A, B, alpha, and beta. By taking alpha, beta, here, this one is represented hybrid scale factor 1, 1. This one is hybrid scale factor 2, 1. Similarly, this is 1, 2, 2, 2. Here, by taking alpha and beta value, four combination comes. So, and A and B is fixed. By putting this value, we draw the graph here. The behavior of the graph is, throughout the time, the energy density range is positive. At the early time, the all the graphs are starting from a positive region, and then when the time are increases, then the graphs are morphs, and then it approaches to zero. So here we can say that our energy density is always positive. This one is the equation of state parameter graph. Here we take A equals to minus 4.4 and B equals to 0.01, our model parameter value. And by taking alpha and beta value, when we draw the graph, at the late time, the graph tends to minus 1. The behavior, we can say that the behavior is goes towards the lambda CDM model. Here also the graphs are at the early times, the graphs are it gradually decelerates, and then at the late time it goes to minus 1. Next, I'm coming to case 2. In case 2, we taken f of qt equals to aq to the power n plus 1 plus bt. And by taking hybrid scale factor and putting this value in our previous equation, we got p, rho, and the equation of state parameter value. Then when we draw the graph here, we see the energy density is positive throughout the range. And it's at the early time, all are coming from different positive region, and at the late time, all graphs are most under tending to zero. Here we take the value of a equals to minus 4.4, b equals to 0.01, and n equals to minus 0.4. Similarly, when we draw the graph of equation of state parameter, the behavior of the graph is like this. At the late time, the graph is tending to minus 1. I mean, it represents to the lambda CDM model. Here, by taking different values of n and alpha and beta, we got this graph. So by observing these two models in case 1 and case 2, here I wrote some conclusion. I mean, that I discussed in result and discussion part. The behavior of energy density and EOS parameter mostly depends on the value of the model parameter A and B, and that of scale factor parameter alpha and beta. It is worthy to mention here that the late time cosmic acceleration behavior can be assessed in dark energy and FRT gravity cosmological model by constraining the parameter of the scale factor alpha greater than 0 and the range of beta is in between 0 to 1 upon 3. I took this range from these two papers. This is essential in getting accelerating cosmological models without invoking any dark energy component to the matter field. Next, we found from our investigation that the model parameter A doesn't affect the evolution aspect of the EOS parameter. However, because in the EOS parameter, A term is absent, that's why. And however, the parameter B affects marginally the behavior of omega. Another parameter n that approaches in the second FQT model has a substantial effects on the EOS parameter, in the sense that with an increase in n, the value of omega at the present epoch increases. Besides the above, we also have used some recent constructed hybrid scale factor to investigate the cosmic dynamics. The hybrid scale factor models provides a signature flipping behavior of the deceleration parameter with early deceleration and late time acceleration. Next, we found the hybrid scale factor models coincides with the concordance lambda CDM value omega equals to minus 1 at late times of cosmic evolution, which is in conformality with recent observations. The hybrid scale factor models predicts the reasonable values of the deceleration parameter at the present epoch, as well as the value of transit redshift. The model parameter are chosen suitable so as to provide a physical acceptable energy density. In view of this model, may be useful in the context of the search for geometrical alternative to dark energy. Now, finally, I want to tell you that I am working with the collaboration with Professor Vibhudat Mishra from BITS Pilani Hyderabad campus and SK Tripathi from in IGIT Sarang. Finally, I would like to thank to the organizer for giving me an opportunity to present my paper in cosmology from home conference. Thank you so much.